the brain is extremely complex. You've got all of these different areas that are involved in different processes, and the different parts of the brain really work together in concert to allow you to think. So whenever there's a concern about something happening in someone's brain, we try and work out what's occurring through a number of different ways, a number of different specialties. You might go on and have an MRI. An MRI really takes high-resolution photographs of the inside of your brain. It's a really incredible technology. You then might want to look at the function of the brain. We use something like EEG, electroencephalography, to try and look at what's occurring in the brain in different conditions. Completely separate to those things, you can come and have a neuropsych assessment, and there what we do is really look directly at how your thinking is working. For example, there are a couple of parts of the brain that are really important in memory, a couple of structures called the hippocampi, and if you have any injury to those structures, we can see changes in your ability to remember things in day-to-day life. There are so many different things that could be impacting your memory. It might be an injury to your brain, but it could also be really poor sleep. It could be relationship difficulties that you're having. It could be something like a depression or anxiety. You may be having a lot of cups of coffee during the day and that's impacting you. So a neuropsychologist is a particular kind of psychologist who measures thinking. A neuropsych typically works as part of a multidisciplinary team. For example, within our epilepsy program, we have the neuropsychologist, we have a neurologist, we have a radiologist, we have a neurosurgeon, all of these different specialties who are all approaching the person's problem, their epilepsy, from a different perspective. The neuropsychologist liaises, speaks with all of those different people to put together the different pieces of the puzzle of what's happening for someone to treat it. If you've been referred for a neuropsych evaluation, your neurologist or your MD, whoever referred you, has probably had some concerns about your thinking. Maybe you've said to them you're worried about your memory getting worse. Maybe you've had a traumatic brain injury. Another possibility is that they're thinking about possible neurosurgery. In that case, the neuropsychologist plays a role by trying to work out if there would be any impact on your thinking from the surgery. If you're coming in for a neuropsych assessment, you really just need to be yourself. You don't need to prepare at all. I'll ask you to remember things, I'll ask you to draw things, I'll ask you to pay attention, and what we can do then is measure those skills, and I can compare you to a whole lot of individuals like yourself, same kind of age, same kind of educational background, and I can work out if you have problems with your memory or your attention or something else. The neuropsych assessment itself takes about 4 hours or so, so it's quite a lengthy kind of exam. Some of them are going to be so easy that it will seem silly, and some of them are going to be too difficult. That happens for literally every person. We have to have a full range of difficulty for our questions so we can work out where everybody sits. We can work out areas of particular strength and particular weaknesses for anyone who we see. If you just take a brief, short assessment, you're going to get a really basic estimate of their thinking, and it may well be wrong. But if you have a detailed assessment, you can have a lot of confidence in what's happening. What you get at the end of a neuropsych assessment is a statement about whether you have particular strengths or particular difficulties with your thinking, if they're expected or they're unexpected, and what we really think the impact has been on your thinking from whatever is happening in your brain. And that lets your neurologist work out if your medications are affecting your thinking, if your seizures are affecting your thinking, maybe you hit your head, fell down a set of stairs. We can say if there's been any impact on your ability to pay attention or to remember things as a result of that, and that will help your neurologist to work out the best way to treat you.